Hello everyone, today we're going to be going over the most fundamental part of any first-person shooter, movement mechanics. So I'm going to go over how movement works in this game and some tips and techniques you can use to get the absolute most out of it. If you learn these skills and learn to apply them, so it's going to have to become muscle memory for you, you're going to do so much better in ordinary situations, but it's also going to vastly increase your ability to clutch, to be the guy who solo survives the ogre, the guy who does the barrel scene in Horde of Magnus by themselves when the rest of the team gets packmastered for no reason, that sort of thing. So let's hop right into it. So, not to be pedantic, but let's just define real quick the basic movement speed as 1. Every weapon has the same basic movement speed. There's a couple different modes of movement. Duck, which obviously is considerably slower. Aim down sight, which is weapon dependent. Block, which is weapon dependent. And dodge, which is also weapon dependent. I'm going to link below a chart that'll go over the movement speeds associated with blocking with each weapon, with aim down sight with each weapon, and with dodge speed and distance. So again, the devs have done a really good job making each weapon feel different, and the impact on its gameplay is very significant. So not to be too pedantic, but let's just establish some basics. Moving in this game, every weapon has the same basic movement speed. Let's just call this 1. Everything will be some multiple of that. So duck, I'm pretty sure, is the same for each character, but you don't use it to move around, so it's no big deal. Block, on the other hand, being able to reposition while defending yourself is a pretty big deal. And the developers have made a pretty good attempt at making each weapon set, so let's say two-handed big weapons versus one-handers, feel different. And they did that by making it so you can only move at a certain speed while blocking. There's also dodge, which I don't see enough people use until maybe the very highest levels, but I see more and more people using it all the time, and it's revolutionary. It changes your whole gameplay. So most of this will be around dodge. So dodge is different for every weapon. It's got different speed and distance. See? And now here's true flight, which has a very slow and small dodge relatively. A big deal. It lets you get away with all sorts of things. There's another mechanic you need to know about. It's called efficient dodge count. So with Elf, with this weapon, with a couple of these other weapons, and with the rapier, you can keep dodging for basically forever. With other weapons, you can only dodge so many times in a row before the dodge starts slowing down and not doing anything. That's your efficient dodge count. So for example, True Flight is 3. A lot of weapons are 3. Sienna's one-handed sword is 3. Kruber's one-handed sword is 3. The Falchion is 3. So you can't spam dodge as much with those. More on that in a minute. So let's hop down and talk about dodge some more. This is mostly going to be...
Are you lost, Mayflies? Where are you?
So with Elf, you can use essentially chain dodge indefinitely. This is what I call
chain dodge. Keep moving, Lumberfoot!
There's a certain rhythm to it. You can only do it as fast as you can do it. If you time it wrong, let's say I'm trying to just do this normally, and you try to dodge too soon, it'll ignore your input. If you do it too fast, it doesn't matter. That's fine. So spamming it as fast as possible, it's no cost to you, and it'll make sure you get the next dodge off when you need to. So what are you going to do? Keep spamming your key over and over again? What are you going to do? Keep spamming spacebar over and over again? I see a lot of people still using spacebar, whatever your jump key is, for dodge and for jump. There's a lot of potential for error in both of those cases. And let's say you're trying to play Kata or Nightmare, and you're trying to dodge an ogre, and you miss and accidentally jump, which is not nearly as fast, and get smacked, you're not going to be having a good day. So let's talk about key bindings and settings. First of all, you're going to want this off. It's going to be a big learning curve for those of you who have gotten used to this, but you want it off. And I was talking to a buddy of mine, Noodle, and what he was saying is that it works well for him 9 times out of 10 because he got used to it. But when he's under a lot of pressure, that's the time it tends to hurt him. And that's the time you want your keys here to be rock solid when you need them to work for you. Enable dodge on jump key. Excuse me, this is what you want off. Dodge on diagonal forward and input. I don't think it makes a huge difference, but I turned it on. If you're very good with this, you can leave it on. I never played the type of game where this sort of thing's important, so it's not easy for me. So I have it off. Sometimes I like to tap one direction or another for other reasons. While I'm at it, I think disabling head shake and camera shake, this is good. It just makes it easier to play. We'll look at keybinds now. This is the big one. I have it as shift, but let me also tell you about something called auto hotkey, or you can do it directly. You can consider this. This is just a tip. A lot of people coming from the Counter-Strike community will already be familiar with this. You can use mouse wheel up and down as extremely consistent ways of spamming some key as fast as you possibly can. So I actually have mouse wheel down as dodge as well. So for example, if I'm venting with Sienna, I'm actually spamming this key. While I'm on it, I actually have Alt for reload, so I can move both left and right while venting. Okay, so enough on that for now. So we talked about dodge spam, or chain dodging as I call it. We set our keys to make it easy to keep doing it, but it only works for Elf and Saltspire, right? Wrong. There's one more type of movement. Well, it depends on what you want to call it. I call it dodge jumping. You can call it dodge reset, but I use reset for something else. So essentially, you only get so many dodges in a row with weapons like True Flight, right? So you get 3, for example. And then the fourth one's okay, and then the fifth one sucks, and then everything from there. So if the efficient dodge count is 3, the fourth one's okay, and everything beyond that sucks. You can dodge, 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 jump. When you do it, watch this carefully. Watch this dodge. Do you see how it goes fast and slows down at the end? You cut off the end of that part at the end, where it's slow, and hit jump. When you hit jump, you're no longer constrained the way you are with dodge. So with dodge, watch what happens when I try to turn my mouse. Do you see how it follows it? It didn't used to be this way. It used to just remember which way you were looking when you dodged and keep going that way so you could move your mouse. But since the 1.5 update, they've made it so that you can curve. Watch. So let's say you're right here. When you jump, it has the effect of basically breaking the dodge, so you can look. So even with Elf or Saltspire Rapier,
Hail
I'll be using
Queen,
this all
take
the time.
Them all.
So
have they no sense
here,
of discipline?
So over here, and I'm also worried about specials or something, I might be doing this for speed, and then every once in a while I'll be doing this. But if I'm Sienna, I'll be doing this every 3 jumps to reset the dodge count. So it's really good synergy between speed and mobility and being able to, you know, keep your head up, pay attention to what the heck's going on. So why dodge? Why is dodge so important? Well, first of all, if you're Elf or any one-hander doing this, chain dodging, or even dodge jumping every third, is strictly faster than just running somewhere. So there is a small increase in raw movement speed. That's not very significant in most cases. Why it's very important has to do with combat. I'm going to do a video extensively about this next week, but just as a teaser, the obvious things are when Ogre comes up to swing at you, you can dodge it 100% of the time. You can also wait for an assassin, and I'll do a guide on this too, but he'll come up to you and you'll see him. If you stop moving, you'll see him look at you and he'll kind of hunker down for a second. That's aiming. You can dodge him 100% of the time. Similarly with Packmasters, if you can tense their knees. With normal rats, if you keep dodging, you can dodge their side attacks. You can even dodge their lunge attacks. So being able to spam dodge as you're running away from a horde or something lets you do it pretty safely. There's another reason it lets you do it safely too, and that has to do with the relationship between the dodge state and other things like block. So when I'm just blocking or aiming gun sight, I slow down depending on the type of weapon I'm using, right? to the degree, so two-hander, I'm slow as balls. If I'm holding block and dodging, block state has absolutely no effect on dodge speed and dodge distance. So this is exactly as fast as this. You get double protection if you do this. The consequence, the cost, is you can't see where you're going. So you need to know the maps. You need to know when to do this. Similarly with attacking. It's a very small decrease in movement speed here. And that's only because you're moving, just normal running, slightly between this. If you haven't noticed, watch my movement speed. Now watch my movement speed. It slows you down. You can actually, let's say you have one, two rats right here, as you're walking by with Sienna, you just do this little dodge. But as you're dodging, you could do a swing and a swing, and you would hardly slow down, and you'd stun them slightly so you don't get hit, and you don't have to waste stamina. Okay. Let's talk about stamina briefly. So you have three shields on the bottom. Each shield is two stamina points. A push for everything but double daggers equals two stamina. Watch how it naturally regenerates. So let's use all our stamina up. If I get hit now, I'm going to go into stun lock. If there are multiple rats, they're going to chain stun me. Watch my stamina. It's not regenerating. When you're dodging, there's no stamina regen. We'll talk a little bit about moving and shooting. So this is 95% plus confirmed for me, as far as I'm concerned. So let's say you have beam staff or handgun or something, and you have a single storm vermin or a packmaster coming at you. Trying to dodge to the side while shooting is inaccurate. As far as I can tell, switching, waiting for the rat in front of you to go to take a swing, dodging back, you're gonna keep moving, oh god, okay, here's the moment, while shooting, you still get an accurate shot. This is with beam staff, I've noticed this a lot. So dodging backwards while getting your shot off seems to be accurate. Another great use for dodge is, let's say you have an ogre, and you're the pot sharer, and the ogre is targeting you. You can kind of walk backwards, have your pot, bait him into a swing, pull back, and drink your pot, and get it off safely. You can do the same thing with bomb, with a horde. Or you can do the same thing with a draught if you need to heal shear your team in the middle of things. So you get your guy up, okay, he's white, I got some stuff on me, I'm gonna keep moving back to the side, I'm gonna pull out my pot, my draught, and I'm gonna pull back a little bit, drink, and quick switch at the same time when you're done, and you're good to go. Let me briefly go over movement speed trinket as well. Movement speed trinket affects almost every state. So it affects block, attack, just plain old run, aim down sight, and it also affects venting movement speed, oddly enough. It doesn't affect two states, and that's crucial. It doesn't affect how fast or how far you dodge at all. And it doesn't affect how fast you are in the air or how far you jump. So if you are jumping all the time, or if you're dodging all the time, or dodge jumping all the time, it'll have practically no impact. However, unless you're doing literally a pure speed run, you're gonna end up doing this occasionally. So it's not
terrible. No giving up now.
It's just, it's not nearly 6%. So let's spawn a horde so we can look at our move speed relative to rat move speed. So I have move speed trinket on right now. So as I'm running, this is 106%. Normally this would be 90% because I have movement speed trinket on, it's an extra 6, so let's call it 95 or so. Let's see if rats can catch me. Just running. Yep. So I'm screwed. Let's try chain dodging. So chain dodging. Let me go back out in the open, though, so we can make sure this is about move speed and not geometry. I can outrun them. Let's try dodge jump.
Alone
even
again.
Just one.
At least I'm in better company now.
Alright. We're alive. I just want to do one more thing. So let's say he's just running after me, or Packmaster, God forbid, or an ogre. Just falling off the edge is a good time to get smacked. Whenever you're going to fall off an edge, instead I recommend that you dodge off. Especially Packmaster and Ogre. You dodge the last shot. Alright, let's move on. So let's let the guard go first way. Let's go for another slide. Let's back up a little bit so they can charge slide. Is hard. The developers have incorporated this by making your movement speed slower in water. So here, look. Land. Water. You see it? Okay. So you can do a couple of things. First, obviously you can try to walk on the land next to the water. Next, it does not affect jump. Lastly, it doesn't seem to affect dodge either. So if you chain dodge or dodge jump in water, it's like you're not even in water. So I brought a Stoker Black Patter to go over a couple little movement tricks. So the first one is pretty simple. The dodge state lets you get through in some other places you couldn't otherwise, but it's slow. Dodge, as you noticed, doesn't really care about other states. It just cares about dodge. So you can put these two together and get right here. Duck dodge. Duck dodge. It comes up getting grim, for example, on the second grim on any row.
Medical supplies, here!
Let's go up some more. Let's talk about air control. So, it's pretty obvious you can jump straight, but you can turn in midair. And this becomes more obvious when you try to put it to use. So we want to get down from here to here without taking fall damage. Maybe to here, let's say. We can try to find something to run into on the way down, which works in some spots, which is also what's called the ladder jump. So let's use both at the same time. You fall, you land on the ladder. A note on the ladder jump trick, if you go up, you take the damage. If you go down, or if you jump before you go up, you do not. So another little trick is called wall catch. So it's completely possible to make this jump. But if you try to do it from the wrong angle, it's a little tough. Of course, it's working every time now.
Watch for stranglers. I'll not
suffer. If you want to get over something like this, this happens on Castle Drakenfels too. Jumping from right next to it doesn't work nearly so quickly and easily as jumping from a bit of a distance. So you hit the apex of your jump before you get to it. Another note, when you get to the top, if you dodge, so dodge near the top of it, it seems to catch the wall and get you over without having to do this waiting to just barely get over. So you don't lose so much momentum. I call it wall catch. You can call it whatever you want. So that move right there, delayed jump, a couple other names known by, essentially you dodge and then a very quick interruption between that and jumping. So instead of dodge, jump, it's dodge, jump. It lets you get to here. You can actually just make this jump. And I don't think I can come up with any examples in this patch where you can make it with a delayed jump. So that's this, dodge, jump. That you can't make with just a perfectly timed jump. It just seems to help you time your jump now. In previous patches, it lets you get a much bigger distance. So last little trick, this one's probably much more useful than the rest of them. Just fall reset. So basically, let's say just fall here. I take damage. And that can stack up really fast if you're dropping just a bit further than that. If instead you hug into some walls, not all walls, but some walls, as you fall, it resets your height so you don't take damage. And that's a fall reset. So that's it for movement mechanics. I hope everyone picked up at least a little something. Next time we're going to go over putting all of these mechanics together to fight hordes, specials, ogres, etc. safely. See you guys.